All right, we're back in the Lost Bastille. This usually takes some doing because it's usually a bit of a trek to make it to the Lost Center after the Sentinels. We'll see if I get invaded. Human effigy is dispersed, like usual. The effect is dispersed, I mean. I don't need to open doors. I need to defeat doors. Do I get attacked here? I feel like something changed here that I might not remember. There we are. I remember you. Yes, I do. What are you doing over there, huh? Alright. Nice try. Any friends? No friends. You should really consider some friends. There's the Bastille key. Oh, look at all those guys. Where'd they go? What happened to all those people? Aww. Those are fantastic. I love the blood pools. Those are just the best new feature, basically. Oh, they removed the fire dude from here. That cliff, I believe, goes nowhere. That's a whole roundabout area that is basically the secret to... what was this? Flame butterfly? Oh god, I remember that specific of a detail. What's wrong with me? There's a whole roundabout area that's how you... It's most useful just for circumventing the ruined sentinels using the antiquated key. I did that last playthrough if you want to see my original playthrough before New Game Plus, if you haven't seen that. But now I'm pretty much taking the standard path towards the center of this episode. Hey, buddy. Bye, buddy. You mummies remain my nemesis. There we go. Mummies are dangerous. Just because of the way they explode, like, they can easily be one of the more damaging things in the game. This is a floating board. Oh well. One day From Software was really gonna nail the whole physics thing. Oh, we have an invader. Hello, friend. Hello, friend. Nice to meet you. How you doing? How nice of you to spawn right in front of me like that. We're using the same shield. We're both heavy hitter douchebags. Isn't that right? Oh, look who's enchanted. Alright. Let's have some fun here. Hey, buddy. Oh, I missed, mostly. That's a bummer. Pokey, 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 pokey! Yeah. The lance is just fun for PvP, I think. Hey, buddy. I can block while I attack. Isn't that fun? Poke! Oh, that was a bad idea. Did not mean to jump attack at all. Hey. Hey, Abud. Abud. What are you up to? You having a good day? You having a good day? What you gonna do? Oh! Oh! I baited a back... He, like, weirdly, like, baited a backstab and then let me just commit to it. There we go. Finish him! He's not off to a good start, is what I would probably say. Hey, buddy. Oh, he doesn't have 100% block, apparently. Or did I enchant this with dark? I don't remember. Look at him strafing circles. He's gonna get me. Yeah. It'd be really satisfying to kill him with a shield. Oh well, I try. I try to have fun here. Fuck your shield! That would have been fantastic to kill him that way. I haven't healed yet, by the way. Honorable PvP here all of a sudden. He's having fun here, huh? Nope, that was a mistake. Nope. He takes chip damage when I do that. Like, that's all I really have to do. Roll. Trying to bait my backstabs here. Son of a bitch. That was getting annoying. I should have switched back to my greatsword. Once he went to the mode where he was just gonna stand around like that and keep trying to bait a backstab, then I should have just switched to my greatsword, because then I could just swing laterally. That is kind of a bummer when someone's like, I'm not here to really fight anymore, I'm just here to keep baiting the insta-kill mechanic. But yeah, I was making mistakes there for sure. A little hard to land a killing blow with this weapon when they're not actually dumb enough to... Well, you know, play aggressively at any point. Because obviously I more or less needed him to attack me to get the right hit in. Oh, that would have been fun. I should have switched to the curved Great Dragon Sword with its... Oh, hello, friend. That would have been really fun if I switched to the Great Dragon Sword and just hit him with the surprise explosive attack. Alright. That's what I get for not healing when invaders go after me. Hey, buddy. Uh-oh. You do what you do, I do what I do. Alright. There we go. Primary threat neutralized. My understanding is that there's a time limit on invasions. So, I don't think I'm gonna get invaded for a while. I think that's what happened last time. I got invaded... I get invaded every time I walk into Lost Bastille on any character, I feel like. If I'm a worthy target or whatever. And I think what happened last time I was here is I got invaded outside in the Bastille, so then when I got to the, gargoyle area, I didn't get invaded. Because no one wanted to invade. I think even for that covenant, it seems that I'm on some sort of cooldown timer for invasions, even though I'm invading a covenant protected area, which seemed weird. I don't know. I've never had the PvP be so dead in such a location before. Wow! I broke the mummy out without killing him. Weird. Fuck your pottery, man. I need some of this shit. Let's go ahead and head upstairs. There's, of course, 100 different, oopsie! Oh, that was low damage. There's, of course, 100 different places where I could go fight the pursuer. I don't know why I can't think of words today. But I'm not in the mood for fighting the 5 versions of the pursuer that are here right now. I was already getting sick of the pursuers last time we played through the area. Am I being attacked? Anyway, there's a bonfire here. I might as well collect. Can I bait these guys out? These guys are way less aggressive than they used to be. I think they're all repositioned, so they're less likely to see you right away. Because this used to be, for me at least, I thought this was the most dangerous room in, all of the Lost Bastille for a while. Because there was just so many goddamn mummies everywhere. But now they just kind of stand there, which is weird in its own way. Open that Bastille key up, and we'll have a shortcut to back outside. Wait, did I open the door to outside? I think I might have left it closed. I might have made a weird one-way situation here if I keep it that way. I should get that actually. I have too many fire. I think I said I have too many fire bombs. I often just pass up on it when I have too much shit. But yeah, in this case it's a spell. So I should make sure I grab it in case I ever feel the need for more. I do have a branch, so I can get straight out of here. It's funny, because before this episode I went and got Ornifex. So I got the end game boss soul vendor before I got the beginning of the game boss soul vendor, which is a weird thing. Let's see. Might as well go into the item box. Let's just grab all my boss souls. God damn, look at all these bosses you guys watched me play against already. And that's not even counting stacks. That's insane. Kind of makes it sink in just how many boss encounters there are when you have that massive catalog of them. There should be roughly... Oh god, I'm so happy I didn't actually swing my weapon. I thought I was about to hit Strayed. Granted, I've killed him before, but I might want to trade with him before I go into New Game Plus at some point. Just clearly is that guy's out. I don't like surprises. Still a bit stiff, I'm afraid. Let's check his vendor. Does he... Great Sword of the Forlorn. There we go, there's the Forlorn set. Might as well just buy that. Can I afford it? I can't afford the whole set, damn it. Because that's new equipment, so I might as well try to get the whole thing. Do I have any... I think I have some soul items to spend here. There we go. Just blow them both, whatever. Yeah, that's overkill. That's fine. It's big for being able to afford this stuff, but small for other concerns. I wonder what kind of comparison I can get from that equipment. Lots of spells. I might farm a bunch of souls and just buy every spell from every vendor before I go into New Game Plus in case I decide to be that next time. Let's look for the old boss souls. No, they're not here. Unless they're over here. He sells spells also. Old Pale Drake Soul, Crystal Soul Spear. That's a pretty high level offensive spell. Blinding Bolt, that's a crazy lightning spell. You need that, that's what we got from Old King. That's actually what we saw that the guy that invaded me in the Iron Keep. He was using that crazy, nonsensical, randomized lightning attack. That was Blinding Bolt. It's kind of a dumb spell, honestly. It's just not reliable in any way. People use it for PvP because at least you can try to hit people that can't react. Numbness. This reduces received damage but darkens one sight. So the soul, I would say that the spell rewards for the old bosses isn't that big of a deal, but the weapons could be. But I think, I'm not 100% sure, but I think you might have to talk to Ornifex for the weapons. I don't know if I think this specific vendor might just not have the old soul upgrades. Anyway, just doing a quick rest, and we're just gonna run through here. And yep. Did I leave? Nope, the door's open. For a second there, I thought I left the door closed. I'm pretty sure you have to pull the lever to open that door, right? That's interesting that you could potentially open the top and drop through without ever opening that through. Helps reduce the idea that that anyone might chase you. Also gives you zero retreat. This is a weird situation. This place is covered in explosive barrels, so it's all ripe for those archers to be shooting flame arrows at you that blow up the explosive barrels along the way as a trap. But I've never once seen those archers up there actually hit one of them before, which makes it seem kind of pointless. It's like a weird setup for a trap that they just didn't really feel like actually going through with, I guess. Or something. I don't know. It's all very strange to me. Alright. Oh. He's gone. Oh, he probably dropped down to attack me or something. Oh, hello. Found him. Please don't kill myself. There we go. Isn't there like an item here? Yeah. Hello. Soul of the Lost Undead, kind of garbage. Yeah, there's a whole cliff over there too, so you can kind of navigate around the edges of this place. There's not really items hidden around to actually warrant that, though. Let's see, no need to rest, because I have full Estus Flasks still, and only the tiniest particle of damage on my weapon. So I'll go ahead and just avoid resetting that guy, if I can avoid it. I'm gonna bring a torch with me, just because there's torches along the way I might as well light up. I like seeing stuff lit up. I like the fact that I can go back towards where Strayed was, and I'll eventually see that perspective anyway, because at some point you just revisit Strayed, and I look out here, and it's all lit up. That's nice. Wait, was there another torch up there that I missed? Oh well. If I did, I'll get it later. I can't remember if there's two up there or not. But I hope that Dark Souls 3 also has a mechanic for just lighting your way through an area over time. That felt like it was missing in Bloodborne to me. But in Bloodborne, I guess it's not as thematically resonant. That game's supposed to be all... There we go. Lovecraftian and about losing your sanity and insight and all that. So having a torch mechanic where you casually light up your environment probably wouldn't be as big of a deal. I think you could light some stuff on fire, but I don't think it had quite the same mechanic that we're dealing with in this game. Ow, rude, dirt. That was just rude, sir. You're gonna have to get punished for that. There we go. Uh-oh, I missed. Tragedy struck. It's definitely awkward fighting with one hand when you're used to using two hand. At the very least, you'd want to have a shield ready. Alright, down we go. And because I'm human, if I wanted to, I could summon Lucatiel down here. Lucatiel of Mira. Or at least I could if I progressed her story enough. I don't know if I've done that. That water texture is freaking out. But as usual, I probably won't. Just do the fight the regular way. And send this, send that upstairs so it's out of my way. Alright. Now that we've created a fire source down here, I can get rid of my torch, but still be able to light my fire without using up a, I can still light my fire without using up a flame butterfly. Didn't they put the Flexile Sentry here, which irritates the shit out of me? Whoa! Hey buddy, you're back! Weren't you gone last time? Did they bring you back in New Game Plus? I could have sworn that you were gone last time and they replaced you with the Flexile Sentry. Oh, who is still here, by the way? Fuck. Fuck, 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 fuck. Alright, that's bad. Let's recover a little bit, because I took some damage. I took damage fast. That was brutal. Hey, buddy. You gonna hang out in the door for me? That's nice. Ow. Let's try to deal with at least one of you from here. Does he come up here? Oh, yeah, he does. He fits. Uh-oh. Accidentally did joystick aiming. There we go. Oop. Gotta be careful with this one. He does a surprising amount of damage. Very quickly. Oh, wait. Doesn't he have lightning damage? I think that... Oh, nope. Nope. Never mind. For a second there, I thought, did I take bonus damage from lightning? Is that how I took so much health damage? Nope. It's, his scorpion spin can do so many blows in a row out of nowhere. Two deaths before the boss. Wow. Not doing so great this playthrough. Hey, buddy, old pal. How you doing? I feel like I have to kill you after what happened last time. Because ideally, I would often just try to get past this area without fighting anything, because anytime the game's like, yeah, fight people in water, that's just the most dreadful experience. God damn, that tail. This is a bad character. This is a bad enemy to fight when you're someone who gets stuck in an animation for a long time. Because he can initiate and complete his whole thing during one of my swings sometimes. Which is rough. No! God damn. You're a big meanie's what you are. Here, can I bait an attack? There we go. Finish him! Down he goes. There we go. Ideally, I would just go past that guy, but after I died against him once, I felt like, oh, I guess I should show that I can take care of him. Are there other ones? Nope. Yep. Bye, Flexile. I already fought you earlier. I don't need to deal with your shit. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, there's surprise mummies. Surprise red mummies. Where are you at, mummy? They're not coming after me anymore? Hello. So I have the Bastille key, so I think I can open this? Yep. All set there. Funny thing is, I get that whole talk about being able to use the avoid using a flame butterfly because I had that thing lit up already. But I'm gonna have to use a flame butterfly because I did not keep a lit along the way. You pretty much have to clear all the enemies out in advance. I went right past it. So many items. You pretty much have to clear the entire path to make it safe to get there with a lit torch, because if you roll, you'll extinguish it in the water. Is there a spot to light up here? No. Because there's so many enemies in the area, you'd end up, oh, hello guys. There's so many enemies around, so you would end up extinguishing your torch every time you roll to dodge a mummy. So you'd have to, like, pre-clear the whole thing, which is kind of a hassle. Instead, you can just get a whole supply of flame butterflies from Ornifex. Hey, lady. I don't know why I said, hey, lady. That's not accurate. Oh, well. I mean, you could be a lady. I'm not gonna question your life choices / how you were born, which is not a life choice. Whoops. Hey guys, don't mind me, just recovering a little bit, having a little R&R. Ow. Ow. Rude. There we go. Yep. Now we're down to just one, so he's easy. Get off my platform. Now you think about what you did. I'm gonna open this door over here. Is he coming after me? He's taking his sweet-ass time, what's going on there. Alright. Oh, right, my torch is busted. Buddy. You get lost? I'll help you. Library's over here! Alright. Yep, alright. Proud of you. You nailed it. You waited outside that door for hundreds of years for the next of chosen undead to come for the lost sinner. And then you kind of hit me a couple times, and then you died horribly. Congratulations! I just get a kick out of imagining the world that these things exist in. Like, that was one of my favorite things about Bloodborne, is that when you're playing through Bloodborne, it looks like stuff's just kind of up to its own stuff. Like, it's already doing things. Like, you go around and, like, various crazy people are praying, having rituals. Some of them are even look like they're working on something. Animals are patrolling around or eating, like the crows are scavenging bodies and all that stuff's going on. In this game, and it really in Souls game, in both games, it's both Souls games so far, and I guess Demon Souls too, they kind of just, there's just dudes standing around, and like that's just their life apparently. They stand there for who knows how long, and then you show up and kill them. And it's like, that was their job, to stand there until you got here. So they don't do a particularly good job at making things feel like they have a reason to exist around here, as opposed to the other game. There we go. So, I'm all healed up. I should have done the effigy first so that my life gem would work, but I think the life gem will keep going long enough to keep healing me. Yeah. Alright, and we're all lit up, so it'll be easier to see in there, and that's gonna be probably a big deal. We'll see how this goes. It's funny how the cutscene shows how dark it gets, and then it just doesn't really get that dark, because I lit everything up. So if they stay true to the original, the vanilla version of the game, there's going to be a nasty surprise waiting for me. Uh-oh. Roll! Wow, I made it. Oh, how did I double roll? I literally hit the roll button one time. I don't know how my character decided to double roll. It looks like I take a healthy chunk out of her hit points when I hit her. Just got to wait for the opportunities. Be very careful, just because of how slow my attack animation is. That I don't get trapped in it for a long time. Ow. No! It's multiple consecutive misses. That's a bummer. Uh-oh. That's gonna be bad for me. Or not. Or I should politely wait for me. There we go. Hit. Rolls tend to be more cost-effective than blocks. Now I can hit her during it. Uh-oh. No! Alright, here's the nasty trick. Here's the nasty surprise. Hey buddies, how you doing? You guys look like a certain character from Dark Souls 1, if I do say so myself. I'm about to get stabbed. Oh come on, that was giving it to her. Alright, so these guys are a dick. Because you have two spellcasters fighting you in the middle of a relatively aggressive boss fight already. Fuck you! Oh cool, they die fast. They die even faster if you hit them, as it turns out. I'm really disappointed that I missed. Okay, she's stuck in an animation for a little while. I'll chug real quick. Yep. Careful. You're the one that's hurt already, right? No! You son of a bitch. Come back here, you shits. Ah, they're fucking rolling. These guys are really frustrating just because there's a bit of luck involved. They can ease... Since they're not aggressively fighting you, they can just casually roll out of the way of your attacks, so you're just waiting for the moment where the AI decides to not auto-dodge your attacks, which can be rough. Rolling sometimes it kind of feels like it's better placed as a player mechanic than it is as a enemy mechanic, because when enemies can do it, a good enough AI could just roll forever and never get hit by you, because it just knows the timing. Holy shit, did you see him he fucking threaded the needle. He managed to run around my character in a way that outpaced his goddamn swing. What the hell? Hey, buddy. Die? There we go. Didn't feel like destroying me that time. Alright. Now we just recover and we take out what's a pretty easy boss fight. Hello, friend. Ah. Rude. Get a few hits in. Hey lady, how you doing? You had a good old time? Ooh, I didn't mean to do that one, but it worked out, I guess. Come over here in the light. I don't really want to play in the dark. It messes with my lock-on range. There we go. I should just be able to finish her now. Nope. Dodge. Rolling strike. Look at them souls. Soul of the Lost Sinner and Old Witch Soul. A nice little couplet. Oh god, I have all my souls with me, so now they're gonna be harder to find. I've made a mistake. Oh, at least they're different. Right, they're different colors. Soul of the Lost Sinner, prisoner of the Sinner's Rise. The Lost Sinner is eternally punishes herself for the sins of the past. They give us very little detail about some of these characters. Old Witch Soul. Soul of the Ineffable. This once magnificent soul continues to exert influence over the land even after the eons have reduced it to these remains. Oh wow, that's all they say. Whoa. I was reading them on separate days, so it didn't click for me, but all four of the old souls say the exact same thing. They don't give you a clue about what those souls are from or anything. I totally lost track of that. Wow, okay. I guess, obviously the weapons you make out of them have to have more information, so like those are where the real descriptions would come from. But anyway, that's pretty much it for this episode. So thanks for always for watching, guys. And if you want to support what I do, maybe check out patreon.com/sebastiansb. Because I'm trying to just keep this all going. And I'll go ahead and let Manus play us out. I mean, not Manus, Aldia, because it's time for him now with our fourth primal bonfire.
May we meet again?